Good morning, Facebook world. We're here bright and early this morning doing a Rocks Digital Live, and we have a special guest with us today, Dave Davies of Beanstalk Internet Marketing. We're going to kick it off with Dave introducing himself right away. Tell us about yourself.
Sure. Well, you know what? You covered the name. So I guess Dave Davies, for those who weren't paying attention, from Beanstalk Internet Marketing, also paying attention. I've been doing SEO since 99 as a black hat affiliate marketer. but moved to the sort of white hat side closer to 2003. So for the kids in the crowd who weren't here then, it was a lot easier.
A lot easier, huh, to do SEO.
A lot. Yeah.
Well, you know.
Go ahead.
Oh, no, go ahead. Write it. What were you going
to
say?
Oh, I mean, back then you could just, for people who don't know, you could basically build 10 sites, link them together, and cram a few keywords in, and you were good to go. So a little different than the era today, which is why we're, talking machine learning and content and all that sort of fun stuff.
It's amazing, isn't it, what the world's came to? You know, I never really considered myself an SEO person. In reality, I'm a social media person. But I learned when my passion for social media was triggered that SEO was so important. And that in order for me to do my job as a social media marketer back in 2009, when I really entered the industry and started my business, was that I had to make sure that my clients had a great website and they had great SEO, because if they didn't, I could drive people to the social media, to their website all day long, but I could not make them drink because their website was not optimized for on page or off page or anything in between. Would you agree with that, the struggle so many businesses have?
I would absolutely agree. And it's interesting, you and I, it seems, came from the opposite angles. I got my start in SEO, and then over time, I've gone, okay, I'll drag kicking and screaming into social media. It's like, all right, well, yeah, I can get them there the first time, but I need to make sure that they're branded to get that second sale or even just that re-engagement or new remarketing strategies after the fact. So, yeah, it's all connected now, and you really don't have a choice.
You're right. In reality, and this is something I guess I've done a lot of speaking on in the last couple of years, is I have found, and I guess I really found this more when I went to the agency side of the house, when I joined Advice Local, I found that the whole strategy is broken. Like, the social media people are not talking to the web developer people. The marketing people are not talking to the web developers or the social media people. And they're all in silos. And when they do that, it's just broken. All of it. All the strategy that people are doing for businesses.
Oh, 100%. And I think that's, you've been to a lot of conferences. I've been to a lot of conferences. I mean, I think that's why I always find it interesting when you hear about the big success stories, the great marketing sort of breakout of a year. Often they're coming from these smaller companies, and it's because they don't have a choice. Their tech guy is also their social media person. They're right, like where you end up, well, okay, maybe tech and social media might not be the greatest connection, but it's also doing the SEO and those sorts of things, where you end up with small teams that are really light. They don't have a choice but to talk. They're in the same room with like no walls, right? Like they don't have a choice but to work together. And so you end up with sort of new strategies, better strategies, because they're having to compete with Amazon. They certainly don't have an Amazon budget. And so they're having to really sort of use their creative juices and connect everything together and come up with strategies that push forward on all fronts.
And that is what makes, just like you said, those campaigns so successful. And now I know at Rocks Digital, you're going to talk about machine learning and how it's changing content. So that's even making it a little bit even more of a challenge. Share with those that have tuned in with us, share just one little tiny thing that you want them to make sure and understand about how machine learning is changing.
Yeah, but you know what? There's a simple way I like to describe it to clients and really anybody. you know, we've been thinking about personalization since 2004. We've been thinking about a whole array of different things Google might be able to do. Wouldn't it be great? It's a dream, or wouldn't that be horrible if they were able to do it? I think a machine learning is basically enabling Google to have an engineer sitting behind me at all times, watching everything I do. I got an Android in my pocket. They know everywhere I've been. And I mean, I have to leave these things on so that I can see what everybody else is seeing. So basically facilitating an environment where they can run calculations so quickly, and they can have machines figuring out what calculations they should run. And we'll, of course, get into this a lot more detail on how to react to that at the conference. But if you just think of it as everything you do can be watched, and every interaction you have with the world around you, and if you're using Gmail, every interaction you have through email can be monitored. You know, and you can think about Big Brother a little bit, but I get excited about it as a marketer going, okay, now I can start to really, really target people. I understand what their interests are. I understand what they clicked on. I understand everything about them in a very new way.
It's, to me, you know, so many, you're right about mentioning Big Brother, people are scared of it, right? And it really can be scary if it's used in a bad way. I mean, but at the same time, it's powerful, and it's amazing what we can do as marketers, but also as business owners, as small business owners, what we can do to make a better experience for our customers and for our consumers.
Well, absolutely. And you can add in, like with machine learning, you can add in functions. A couple weeks ago, Google added in the capabilities on iOS to, you know, we've all used the navigation on our phones, right? And you can now select a different kind of vehicle. Well, if Google understands, did you click on a sedan? Did you click on a minivan? How do you associate? There's just one more little piece of information. And so now what makes me sort of salivate on that one is, as a paid search marketer, when I see them creating audiences and go, okay, now you understand that this is, you know, I own a minivan. I'd probably pick a minivan for mine. So, okay, now Google's just learned something new about me. They know what my gas consumption is going to be. They know that I probably have a couple kids, and I do. You know, they can learn a new thing about me just by the fact that I'm picking a minivan over a sedan as my vehicle.
Yeah, you're absolutely, you know, it's interesting when you think about that, when you say that. I mean, it, and they can deliver you ads based on that when it's time to buy a new one. You know, Dave's had his vehicle this long, and it seems like based on his, you know, driving patterns and all that, he's probably at around this many miles. And based on that, it's time for maybe an oil change. So they're going to drop you an oil change coupon or an ad for that. Or maybe they're going to deliver you it's time to buy a new car ad, or who knows, maybe it's a car seat because somehow they've also figured out that your wife is pregnant. You know,
probably listening in on the phone with when I'm chatting about the more gray hair that I'm getting. We've talked a lot about SEO. And one of the things that we'll also be covering during the session that's probably of interest too is when we're thinking about the capabilities of machine learning, understand that basically it makes them not just an engineer sitting behind me watching everything I do and sitting behind me in my minivan while I'm driving around, but running our probabilities. If I run a search for something like Miami real estate, okay, I'm probably looking for you know, a house. There's a good chance I'm looking for a house, but there are probabilities that I'm looking for something else. I'm a high school student looking up what are the market statistics, right? I'm a university professor trying to find different metrics in there. So if we use that and understand that Google, when they're running, you know, putting out the here's our top 10 results or top 8.4, which the odds are now, if we can use our content to make sure that we're hitting as many of these points as possible in a constructive way to increase the probability that our website fulfills more user intents, and that's going to be a big part of the session, then we now have maximized our odds that our site's going to rank because we fulfill the greatest number of possible user intents. And of course, Google just cares that their user's intent is fulfilled when they click that link. And that's the part that's really exciting to me. And there's actually some math you can run to figure out what your probabilities are. So
you're right about that, Dave. It's all about those micro moments, right? As Google started pushing, what, back in 2015, micro moment this, micro moment now. That now they call it something different. They're not pushing the micro moment phrase as much because it's been so overused. But it is about those moments. I have them all the time, you know, where I want to know how to do something. I Google it. I want to know where to go. I want to, whatever it is, I immediately pick up my phone for it. I'm not, even if I'm sitting at my MacBook Pro or, you know, on my laptop or at my iMac, I still pick up my phone most of the time to Google it because it's faster, right? And it's just a habit. I even like to read my email on my phone more than from my computer. Is that crazy? It's less of a commitment to have to reply, right?
Well, indeed. And then you end up with the you know, added benefits of being able to use voice search on your phone a lot more easily than on your computer. So there's a lot of advantages.
So I'm an iPhone user instead of Android, and Siri never understands me. I was just going to say, go ahead. What were you going to say? Because I was going to wrap up.
I was going to know that's almost blasphemy to me. No, iPhones are great for people who like them. I suppose.
So I take it you're not a Mac user then.
I am not. I looked at the cost because I have six monitors, and I looked at the cost of trying to pull that stunt off on a Mac and went,
it's hard. No. You can't. It is complicated. That's why you just invest in the 27-inch iMac, and then you can have lots of screens. Thank you so much for coming on today. I'm really looking forward to your presentation at the Rocks Digital Marketing Conference on June 29th and June 30th. Really quickly, for those listening, I like to give a code to all the speakers. So if you love Dave and what he had to say, use the code Beanstalk Rocks, and you can get 35% off a 1 or 2 day ticket. So with that, thanks for coming on today, Dave Davies. And I'll actually give a shout out real quick to your podcast that's coming up.
Perfect. On Thursdays at 11 Pacific, every week, we do a show called Webcology on webmasterradio.fm. And this week, we have Bill Hartzer, Michelle Simpson-Ross, and the person interviewing me right now, Lissa Duty, coming on to chat Rocks Digital and a bunch of other SEO-y, nerdy, local SEO, social media-y kind of stuff.
I love how you describe that so much. Again, thanks for coming on, and we look forward to seeing you really soon. Everybody, have a great day. Come back for our next live at 1 o'clock Central. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.